Watch those wrist rockets!
Hello everyone, and welcome back to another video. Now, in my review for last week's episode of The Mandalorian, I had this to say. And it's kind of annoying that most of this 40-minute episode is just filler, but as long as the filler exists to set up for an even better episode next week, then I am happy. And true enough to form, that's exactly what happened. The newest episode of The Mandalorian came out, and it blew everyone away, including me. And today, that's what we're going to be talking about. Before I begin this week's review, let me first give a quick spoiler warning, because this video will contain spoilers, and for those of you who have not seen Chapter 11 of The Mandalorian yet, go watch it right now. It is such a good episode, and for those of you who have seen the episode, enjoy the video. The first thing I noticed about this episode that I really liked was the music. Just like Chapter 11, this episode had really great music, and I thought the music fit the setting of the episode really well because it has the same like style of the Mandalorian music, but since the episode takes place on like a watery planet, it has like a more like, you know, ocean, like deep ocean music vibe. I don't know, that doesn't really make any sense, but like, it really, like, feels like music you would find from, like, a, you know, ocean documentary or something, but it still has the same, like, Mandalorian music vibe to it. Yeah, the music was really good, and yeah, it fit the setting really well. Something I really didn't like about the last episode of The Mandalorian was Baby Yoda, because I thought he was really annoying, and I really didn't like how he was eating the poor frog lady's eggs. I thought that kind of made him the antagonist more than anything, but in this episode, Baby Yoda is the one that gets eaten, actually, so yeah, I did not expect that to happen, but you know, justice. Baby Yoda deserved it. He was eating the poor frog lady's eggs, and now he gets eaten. And I did like how Baby Yoda eventually became, like, friends with the, like, you know, eggs that he, like, ate in the last episode. Because, like, you know, after the eggs get born or whatever, then he, you know, he becomes friends with them in a sense. So I did kind of like that. He has a bit of a redemption, you know? So yeah, Baby Yoda, he's back to being a cute little baby. So, you know, Baby Yoda gets a thumbs up for me in this episode. And yeah, no, let's stop talking about Baby Yoda because there are so many other stuff to discuss. And yeah, by far, one of the most surprising moments of this episode was when Bo-Katan shows up to save Mando. That is such an epic moment because Bo-Katan is in The Mandalorian, guys. That is just such an epic, like, just the fact that she's in this series at all is so cool for two reasons. One, because she's just an awesome character in the Clone Wars and Star Wars Rebels. Like, overall, Bo-Katan is just a really solid character. And yeah, I'm so glad she's in the series. And number two, that is another rumor that came true because, like, a couple months back, there was a rumor that, ooh, Bo-Katan's gonna be in The Mandalorian and everything. And yet again, that's like the second rumor, and yeah, that's the second rumor that's come true, and another rumor is confirmed to be true later in the episode, but more on that later. And yeah, the fact that she's in this is so great for multiple reasons. Yeah, and then she's just such a cool character. I love her interactions with Mando. I love the moment when she takes off her helmet and Mando's like, wait a minute, I thought you guys were Mandalorian. Something's not right. I just thought that was like a really cool moment because he sees how like different Mandalorian cultures react. Overall, I just really like the way they like interact because they're a part of two different Mandalorian, you know, Mandalorian clans, I believe the right word is. And yeah, I just really like that. I also really liked the scene where they took over the Gazanti cruiser. I really like the fact that a Gazanti cruiser is in this show at all because I think they have a really cool design. And you know, it's really cool to see them in live action. And yeah, I think it's just a really cool scene. The music is perfect, the action is perfect, the editing is perfect. It's all so good. And I love the moment when Bo-Katan and that, like, you know, Imperial officer guy are talking about the Darksaber. And I think it fits with Bo-Katan's character perfectly for her to want the Darksaber. And it's nice that this show brings up the Darksaber again, because I think it's a really cool weapon, and I love the significance it has and everything. And yeah, it's honestly a great scene, not to mention later after they take over the Gazanti cruiser, when Bo-Katan tells Mando about Ahsoka Tano. She tells him to go get Ahsoka Tano and then get help from her. Like, that is epic. That's the third rumor that's come true in this series. It's amazing. That's three rumors. Like, how many other rumors are gonna come true, honestly? Like, and just the fact that she, like, is, like, you know, in this series at all is epic. Like, dude, seeing her in live action, played by Rosario Dawson, is gonna be epic. And yeah, I know she's gonna be played by Rosario Dawson, because that's what, you know, the whole rumor was. But yeah, no, it's gonna be incredible to see her in live action for the first time ever. This season is taking so many things that were previously only seen in animation and making them live action, and I just think it's so cool how they're doing that. I cannot wait to see Ahsoka. And yeah, I mean, that it's just been a really great episode all around. I just thought the settings were great, the like whole vibe of the episode were great. I love Bo-Katan and, you know, Mando's interactions with each other. I thought that was, like, you know, really good. I like how they interact, and I just like how Bo-Katan was in this series at all. I just think that's really cool. And yeah, there's a lot to love about this episode. So if we go over to the tier list, yes, as you might notice, I did make some changes to the tier list. I changed the rank of NB. I changed that to M, which stands for meh. So, like, you know, I'll put, you know, episodes in there that, like, you know, they're just meh episodes. So yeah, so if any a meh episode, I'll put it in there. And yeah, as you can see, I did move the Passenger episode. I moved that episode down one rank just because I thought it'd be more fitting to, you know, move it down. I didn't really think it deserved an A ranking anyway. So yeah, it's in the meh ranking now. But yeah, so for this episode, the Heiress, this episode, Heiress, I believe it's called, yeah, Heiress, I don't even know, is that how you pronounce it? I don't know. But yeah, Heiress, it will be ranked in I, definitely in I. Like, it's probably closer to Siege of Mandalore than, you know, the season premiere, because yeah, it's honestly a great episode. So it's at least as good as the season premiere, but you know, it might be just a little bit better. But yeah, so it's definitely in an I ranking. And yeah, no, this episode, the Heiress, great episode. I love it. So good. So many things to love about it. Like I said before, you know, gave Baby Yoda a redemption arc and so much great stuff. So yeah, all around great episode. I cannot wait to review next week's episode. But I think that will wrap up this week's review. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you next time.